हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी. आई एम डॉक्टर सोनिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन, अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज, इंदौर. टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इंट्रानेटल केयर. राइट, इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर MCH वी हैव कवर्ड द इंट्रोडक्शन एंड द एंटीनेटल केयर. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज इंट्रानेटल केयर. सो इट इज़ डिफाइंड एज द मैनेजमेंट एंड डिलीवरी ऑफ केयर टू द वुमेन इन लेबर. And the five cleans which you can see here are the clean hands and fingernails, clean surface, clean blade, clean cord tie and clean umbilical stump. The aims of good intranatal care are through asepsis, delivery with minimum injury to the infant and the mother, readiness to deal with the complications like prolonged labor, antepartal hemorrhage, convulsions, malpresentation, prolapse of the cord. Okay, so this previous slide, I am focusing on again five cleans: clean hand, clean surface, clean blade, then clean cord tie and clean umbilical stump. These are very important as they are often asked in your pre-PG question also. Okay, then the complications you can deal during the labor, during the intranatal care are prolonged labor, APH, convulsions, malpresentations and the prolapse of the cord. Now, care of the baby at delivery, if after delivery, what all you have to see in the baby. So, I think you should know that ABC also, you must be knowing that you have to clean the airway, you have to check the breathing, you have to clean the surface and clean the baby. So, ABC, and you have to see the circulation also. So, resuscitation, care of the cord, care of the eyes, care of the skin, Apgar score, maintenance of body temperature and breastfeeding. Now, delivery kits, which are very important and should be available at the place of delivery. Okay, so midwifery kits are the sterile gloves and drapes, towels, then cleaning material and sterilizing equipments. Disposable delivery kit, if you say, they will include the sterile cord tie, the blade, the spirit, the ergometrine injection. Now, normal labor, we are just quickly brushing through it because intranatal care deals with the procedure during delivery. So, we are just going to brush up four stages, stage 1, 2, 3 and 4. Stage 1 is the onset of true labor pains to the cervical dilatation. We all know that. Stage 2, from full cervical dilatation to delivery of fetus. Stage 3, after the delivery of fetus to the placental delivery. And stage 4, placental delivery to 1 hour after the delivery. Okay, please go through it. They are very simple. Domiciliary care. This is often asked in the viva also and as a very short note also. Okay, so mother with normal obstetric history may be advised to have their confinement in their own home, provided the home conditions are satisfactory. Okay, it is conducted by the health worker female or a trained dai. As you must have seen in the healthcare delivery system, we have discussed that the dai is trained in the delivery for 30 days. She is provided with a certificate, and before that she is also has to conduct minimum 3 deliveries. And she is also provided with the delivery kit. So, this helps in the domiciliary care. Then, female health worker trained to recognize the danger signs and reference. Okay. So, a patient with a good obstetric history can undergo the labor at home itself with the help of midwife, means trained dai or the health worker female, and if there are any danger signs present in the patient, then she can be referred. Sorry for the wrong word. Then danger signs like what? Sluggish pain or no pains after the rupture of member. If there is no pain also, or if it there is sluggish pain also after the rupture of membranes, it is dangerous. Then pain for an hour after the rupture of membranes, but no progress in labor. Okay, progress in labor in the stimulated time frame is also very important. Then prolapse of the cord, meconium stain liquor, slow, irregular, excessive fetal heart rate, excessive bleeding during the labor. So these are the danger signs which you must have seen here. Okay. collapse during the labor, placenta not separated within half an hour after delivery, postpartum hemorrhage, collapse, temperature of 38 degree or over during the labor. Okay, so see, again we are brushing through the danger signs. That what are the danger signs? Again I am repeating, sluggish pain or no pain after the rupture of membrane, pain for an hour after the rupture of membrane with no progress of labor. Then if there is prolapse of the cord, then meconium stained liquor, slow, irregular, excessive fetal heart rate, excessive bleeding during the labor, then collapse during the labor, placenta not separated within half an hour after delivery, and postpartum hemorrhage collapse, and a temperature of 38 degrees or over during the labor. Then what are the advantages of domiciliary care? Now see, in the home we are allowing the patient to deliver in the favorable conditions of home, because in an institution we prefer 90% institutional delivery. But what happens is that sometimes the patient is not cannot cope up with the conditions present, and in the present scenario of corona, everybody is frightened to visit a hospital. Okay, so domiciliary care means what? You have to provide a very suitable environment to the patient so she can deliver very calmly at home itself. So what are the advantages? We'll quickly see in this slide. Number one, the delivery is in the familiar condition. Okay, then second is, chances for cross infection are fewer than the hospital, obviously, and in this present scenario of corona it's very helpful. Then mother is able to keep an eye upon her children and domestic affairs, and this may tend to ease her tension. Okay, so if she is having a previous child and she has a responsibility, domestic care also, she can take care of everything, so she will be tension free. Otherwise if she goes to the hospital, her half mind is at home only, that what my husband is going to eat, how is the house going to be cleaned, how is the other baby, what he or she is doing. Okay, so if it is at home, she can take care of these things and she can be released of the tension. Now disadvantages, of course something pros and cons are present everywhere. So disadvantages of domiciliary care are, the mother may have less medical and nursing supervision than the hospital, obviously. If you take all precautions also, five cleans also, which we have discussed, but something or the other, that is the nursing or the medical supervision, that what has to be done and how more properly the care has to be taken, that will be lagging. Okay, second is, the mother may have less rest. Why less rest? Because in the hospital, during the LSCS, if you talk about, they discharge in a week or maximum 5 days. Okay, and in normal delivery they discharge at 2 days or 3 days some places. Okay, so she takes a rest for that stimulated time period. But in home, what will happen if she'll deliver and soon after she'll feel better, she'll be back to work, so she'll not be able to get that stipulated time frame for the rest. So rest will be less in case of the domiciliary delivery or domiciliary care. She may resume her duties soon. Her diet may be neglected. Now whatever the others will eat, she'll again make that, she'll eat that only, so her diet will be neglected, which is very important during this postpartum period. Now what is institutional care? About 1% of deliveries tend to be abnormal and 4% are difficult, requiring the service of the doctor. So it is recommended for all high risk cases. Okay, now what are the high risk cases? We'll talk about anemia, heart disease, eclampsia, short stature, diabetes, jaundice, tuberculosis, oligohydramnios, malpresentations, etc. These are the high risk cases. Okay, now what is rooming in? Rooming in is also very important. Pre PG mein bhi puchte hain, viva mein bhi puchte hain, aur theory mein bhi very short note mein aa sakta hai. So rooming in is what? keeping the baby's crib by the side of the mother's bed. Opportunity for the mother to know her baby. Chances of breastfeeding is more. Confidence that her baby is not misplaced. Okay, so these three points you have to keep in mind, that when you keep the baby's crib side to the mother's bed, that is called rooming in, and it ensures the mother that her baby is not lost, not misplaced. Then she'll breastfeed more and more timely, and it will be an opportunity for the mother to know her baby more and more. So this is rooming in. Then obstetric emergencies, if you talk about, which you have to take care, okay? So these conditions always need referral. Number one, the postpartum hemorrhage. If you have blood loss more than 500 ml and you have increased pulse rate, decreased blood pressure, okay? Blood pressure is decreasing, the pulse rate is increasing, and the blood loss is more than 500 ml, then it is very important. Then you talk about sepsis. The infection of reproductive organs leads to infertility and pelvic inflammatory disease. Now, causes are unclean delivery techniques, prolonged labor, and complicated deliveries. Third is the obstruction and prolonged labor. Now, there is no progress of the labor despite of uterine contractions. The causes can be, number one is CPD, that is your cephalopelvic depth, okay? Abnormal presentations, congenital anomalies, etc. Then rupture uterus in obstructed labor. The causes can be injudicious use of oxytocin, previous operative scar, manual removal. And last is the retained placenta. Okay, again we are just brushing up through the obstetric emergencies. Number one is the postpartum hemorrhage, when there is more than 500 ml of blood loss, the pulse rate is increased and the blood pressure is decreased. Then sepsis, the infection of reproductive organs lead to infertility and the PID. Causes can be undelivery techniques, the unclean delivery techniques, prolonged labor, complicated delivery, then obstruction and prolonged labor, rupture uterus and retained placenta. Now, what is the position of mother during transportation? This is very, very important. So, in left lateral position, this is a pre-PG question also, or Viva mein bhi puchte hain. Theek hai, position kya honi chahiye mother ki during the transportation. So, it is very, very important. So, in the left lateral position, to prevent the asphyxia, risk of inhalation of vomitus is decreased, uterine pressure is prevented on the IVC and the aorta. Then medications which you can start during the transportation are, start IV fluid, sedate before transportation, and first dose of antibiotic should be given. Okay, so the lesson which we learn from the intranatal care, which is very important, is as provision of intranatal care depends not only on the medical but also on the social and cultural practices prevailing. The need to educate women and their families should be emphasized for a safe and normal delivery. Okay, so it's very important that the intranatal care, it not only depends on the hospitals, the medical institutes, but also on the social and the cultural practices also which are running in the families. So the emphasis should be to educate the women and to emphasize on safe and normal delivery. Okay, so in this video and in this part of the chapter, we have discussed about the intranatal care. You have to know the definition, that is during the labor what all is important. Okay, when the patient comes in labor, then the four stages of labor, then what is domiciliary care when you provide home delivery, okay, with all precautions. Then what is rooming in when you keep the baby's crib at side of the mother's bed. Then what are the advantages, disadvantages of domiciliary care, rooming in, okay? And then what are the complications which you have to face at the time of labor, and how you have to transport the patient properly with the IV fluid, antibiotic and left lateral position. So this is all about the intranatal care. It can be asked in the Viva VOC. It can be asked as a pre-PG question. Some MCQs may be made from it. And it can be also asked in a short note of, I think, 4 or 5 marks. Okay. So if you have any doubt, please do ask it. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay at home and stay safe.